السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon all conditions. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his entire household, all his companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless every single one of them and every single one of us as well and our offspring to come up to the end. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all Jannah. Ameen. My brothers and sisters, we saw yesterday that in Surah Taha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Musa alayhi salam and Harun alayhi salam that when they go to Fir'aun, the Pharaoh, they should speak politely, they should speak with soft words, they should speak in a way that perhaps he might take heed. From this we learn that no matter who we talk to, we need to maintain our own respect whenever we are speaking. Here there was someone very arrogant, very haughty, who used to scream and yell, and at the same time he used to argue, he used to debate, he used to claim he was the best. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you don't argue, you don't scream, you don't yell, you only use beautiful words. Verse number 44. فَقُولَا لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ أَوْ يَخْشَى. Two of you, go to him and speak to him with soft words. Perhaps he may be reminded, perhaps he might fear Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. We should remember, consistency on a very polite note is far more beneficial than screaming and yelling. And remember, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was sent to Fir'aun. None of those whom we are going to call towards Allah can be worse than Fir'aun, the Pharaoh. And none of us can be better than the Prophet Musa alayhi salam. All the more reason for us to be even softer in our approach. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us wisdom. Then I want to move on to a prostration made mention of in Surah Taha and in various other surahs. There are two prostrations that we speak about. One is a prostration that was not done when they were instructed. That was something we spoke about some episodes back. If you recall, we had said when the angels were instructed to prostrate to Adam alayhi salam, they all prostrated, but Iblis, who was made from the fire, he was from among the jinn, he refused. And because of that refusing of prostrating to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, by the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, once he was cursed. He was arrogant. He didn't turn back. In these verses, we see a prostration of people who were engaging in wrong because they admitted their fault, because they admitted they were wrong and they fell prostrate. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave them. So this is another prostration being spoken about. We need to ask ourselves which category we fall into. Do we fall into the category where Allah is telling us to prostrate for His sake in the form of salah and we don't? Or do we fall into the category of those whom as soon as they find a moment, an opportunity to fall prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they do so? Allahu Akbar. Look at what Allah says about the magicians, and I'm sure you know that the story of Musa alayhi salam, the Prophet Moses, may peace be upon him, these magicians were brought by Fir'aun, the Pharaoh, and they were told to compete with Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. As they threw their sticks and their ropes, they seemed like they were serpents moving, but as soon as Musa alayhi salatu wasalam threw his stick, it changed into a huge snake and it swallowed everything that they had made. Immediately they knew, this is not magic. This is a reality. This is something else. They fell prostrate. Allah says, verse number 70, فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحَرَةُ سُجَّدًا قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ هَارُونَ وَمُوسَى. The magicians fell prostrate immediately and they declared, we believe in the Lord of Harun and Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Amazing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we forgave them, we granted them paradise as a result. And you know how strong their belief was? They had accepted Iman, and moments later, Fir'aun started threatening them. He says, I will slaughter you, I will crucify you, I will punish you, I will beat you, I will cut off your hands and your legs, etc., etc. Do you know what they said? Do as you wish. We are not going to be intimidated by you. Allahu Akbar. Pause for a moment. Today, things happen across the globe in the name of Islam that have nothing to do with Islam. As a result, people start hating on the Muslims. As a result, you find people bringing along more and more rules and regulations governing what they should do to Muslims and how they should treat them. So by default, if you walk through the airports and you have a beard or you are dressed in hijab or you are identified as a Muslim or your name is some Muslim name, you will be stopped and you will be told that you are being searched at random. That random means you're a Muslim. That's what it means. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. But what I learned from this verse is these magicians were not intimidated even though they were persecuted in the real sense. Today, people just want to search. They want to make sure because of a stereotyping. I'm not saying that's right at all, but I am saying, brothers and sisters, don't give up your faith as a result. People say, I'm going to the United States, so I'm going to shave my beard and I'm going to wear a suit. I tell you, those who perpetrate the crimes, I haven't seen them with huge beards, etc. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. A lot of them don't even have beards. They were frequenting the clubs, etc. One wonders what Islam they were following. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deep understanding. So my brothers and sisters, it's important to learn a lesson from these who believed in Allah. Moments later, they decided, hang on, we're not going to give up. Not at all. Please, let's not give up our faith. People will watch us. They see our dedication. They witness how good we are, how kind we are, how we reach out to everyone. Wallahi, they will come to Islam. If all of us had to hide, how would people know the qualities of true Muslims? It's because of you and I who try our best to be good that other people get to know about Islam. They realize it is indeed a valuable faith. What a powerful point. So save yourselves from earning the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Save yourselves from, subhanallah, losing yourself just because you are worried about what people are going to think about you. They can think what they want. Allahu Akbar. These magicians, when they accepted Islam, do you know what they said? Verse number 72, they tell the Pharaoh, فَقَضِ مَا أَنْتَ قَاضٍ إِنَّمَا تَقَضِي هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. You can judge, you can rule, you can do what you want and pass any judgment against us. We want you to know that you only have a little bit of control in this world. After that, you have nothing. So you might punish us here for a temporary period of time, but we would like our Rabb, whom we are going to go back to forgive us. إِنَّا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّنَا لِيَغْفِرَ لَنَا خَطَايَانَا وَمَا أَكْرَهْتَنَا عَلَيْهِ مِنَ السِّحْرِ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. We have believed in our Lord in order for us to achieve forgiveness from our sins and what you forced us to do in terms of this magic in order to try and prove a point. And we want you to know that Allah is better and everlasting. You are not everlasting. You're going to come to an end. My brothers and sisters, the same applies to the difficulties we have on earth. They will not last forever. Today you have a problem, tomorrow you will smile because the problem will be solved. And what will happen? Ultimately, you will meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you goodness, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you eternal success. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us paradise. So these are the beautiful lessons that we learn to save ourselves from this type of difficulty, from this type of sin, and from this type of behavior.